If you're a kid, this happens 8 to 10 times a year. An adult, 2 to 4. It's the common cold, and we've all had it. What is the best thing to do about it? What is available to treat it? What is effective, and what is not? In this video, we're going to let you know what you can do to help you get through it. Welcome to Family Med, your medical home for practical and accurate information to help your family make healthy decisions. I'm Dr. Eric Richardson, and my passion is helping you cut through all the health information clutter out there on the internet. If that sounds like the kind of information you or your family needs, make sure you follow along with us. Hit that subscribe button and share it with your friends. Okay, so today we're talking about the common cold. We've all had it, and in fact, maybe you have it right now, and that's why you're watching this. Hopefully you've watched our last video where we talked about what is the cold and when you should go to the doctor for it. If you're new here and haven't seen it, then check it out. It's got a lot of good information for you. Today we're going to approach this assuming that you have the typical cold symptoms, that there isn't any concerning things that would make you want to seek additional care. Again, for a list of those, refer to my other video. Today, we're just going to focus on those things that you can do for yourself or that you can even go pick up over the counter that can help you get through this. When we talk about treating the cold, it's important to remember that a cold is caused by a virus, so we don't have anything that can just cure it. Antibiotics are worthless in trying to treat it, and because nobody's really come up with that elusive cure for the cold. Well, because of this, most treatments just focus on treating the symptoms. So what can you do for example, the congestion, runny nose that happens? If you're over the age of 6, then there are some medication options. The three most common are your pseudoephedrine or Sudafed, phenylephrine, or the nasal spray oxymetazoline or Afrin. Your Sudafed and phenylephrine are oral medications. The phenylephrine is found on the shelves in all of your cold medications that have a decongestant in it. It can help some. Now your Sudafed or Pseudoephedrine is a little more effective, but this you have to purchase from the pharmacist behind the counter. Afrin, it can be helpful, but you can only really take that 2 or 3 days in a row. Using it any longer and your nose can get addicted to it. So, for non-medication treatments, or if your child is under 6 years old, there are some options you can try. The most helpful are saline nasal drops. These can help relieve congestion by loosening up mucus, as well as drying up those nasal passages. In infants, you can clear their congestion by using saline nasal spray or drops, and then using a bulb syringe to clear it. It's also really helpful to do a sinus rinse, using one by maybe Neal Med or Neti Pot. Check out my video on sinus infections for a better description of these. Also, keeping the air more humid with an in-room humidifier can also provide some relief. So what do you do about those aches and pains or that sore throat? Well, the most common treatment for these are your over-the-counter pain medications, such as acetaminophen or Tylenol, and ibuprofen or Advil-type products. These can be very effective. I'd suggest that you look at the recommended doses on the bottles. I've talked about this before in other videos, but you can even alternate taking ibuprofen and Tylenol to help control your symptoms. Follow your doctor's advice, but I oftentimes will recommend to my patients alternating each one about every 3 hours, making sure you don't take each one individually sooner than 6 hours. Now, be careful to avoid aspirin in children and teenagers. This can cause a rare but potentially life-threatening condition called Reye syndrome. You can also use salt water gargles. Just take a teaspoon of salt, put in some warm water, and just gargle. The salt helps decrease some of the swelling in the throat. So what's available to treat a cough? First of all, it's important to point out that this has been a subject that's been studied quite a bit. Unfortunately, there isn't anything on the market that has shown a significant level of improvement in controlling the cough. There are products available, however, none of them tend to be safe under the age of 4. So, but the most common one we see in the over-the-counter medication is one called Dextromethorphan. You tend to find this as the ingredients in most of your multi-symptom cold medications. It can help somewhat, but nothing significant. There are some studies, however, that have shown a potential benefit of an antihistamine called chlorpheniramine. This seems to be more effective for those lingering cough that you get when you have a lot of that drainage kind of going down the back of your throat. Remember though, if you give cough medication to an older child, make sure you follow the label directions. Don't give your child two medicines with the same active ingredient. Too much of a single ingredient could lead to an accidental overdose. There are also some natural over-the-counter medications that are for sale, like, for example, your Zarbee's honey-based products. These are safe to use for children over the age of 1. There isn't really any great data to suggest whether they're effective or not, but they are felt to be safe and okay to try. So those are the most common over-the-counter products that are available, but how about the alternative medications? What are some different supplements that are out there, and what does the data say about it? The most common alternative cold medications out there that have been studied are vitamin C, echinacea, and zinc. So let's look at vitamin C first. A lot of studies have been done looking into the role that it has in fighting colds. Unfortunately, there isn't a great consensus in the data. The most recent studies show that daily use doesn't seem to help prevent colds, but it does seem to help you overcome them a little bit quicker. The most success was seen when at least 6 to 8 grams a day of vitamin C was taken right at the onset of symptoms. This did seem to help decrease the length of a cold. In general, it's safe to take, so there isn't harm in trying it and see how you respond. Now, the only caveat is that those who have significant kidney disease should avoid high doses, as well as if you're pregnant. The next one's echinacea. Studies on the effectiveness of echinacea at preventing or shortening colds are mixed. The evidence has shown a slight trend towards benefit and prevention, but not clear enough to have a definitive answer. However, if you're otherwise healthy, it's unlikely to cause harm. We're just not sure how safe it is to take long-term, though. In fact, there is some suggestion that use longer than 8 weeks can actually decrease your immune system. So talk to your doctor on this one and see what they think is right for you. Okay, the last one is zinc. Zinc's another medication that is recommended frequently for treating and shortening the duration of colds. Like most supplement medication, the data is up and down on this one, even for the common cold, but mainly I think due to a lack of good quality studies. However, when they've done a big analysis of all the different studies, it does appear that taking zinc can help shorten the duration of colds. The hard part of this is that there really isn't any consensus in how much and how often it should be used. It did show that you tend to do better if you start it right at the very onset of a cold. However, one thing you ought to remember, you do want to avoid the nasal zinc treatments as it can be toxic to the nerves that help you smell and can cause irreversible loss of smell. Zinc can be limited as well to its side effects such as bad taste and stomach upset. So that's it. If you missed anything, go back and watch or check out the notes section below for a review of what we talked about today. Now, I hope you found this information we presented today to be useful. If you did, don't forget to like, subscribe, and even hit that notification button, as well as share it with your friends. This really is key to helping me be able to continue to produce this kind of content for you. Also, let me know what you think in the comments below. What have you found to be helpful in treating your colds? Is there anything that you use that we haven't talked about? Let us know in those comments below. Okay, now remember, my purpose in sharing this information for you is to educate you on things that you can think about in trying to make decisions in your own health. In no way should it be taken as direct medical advice to you or in your own situation. So please consult your own doctor for concerns regarding your specific situation. All right, so as a thanks for those who stuck around, here's your bonus tip. We all know that when getting a prescription, it's always cheaper to get one that's generic. There are sometimes, however, times that getting a new one in a name brand is a better option for you. If your doctor decides that this is better for you, make sure you ask them for a coupon. Most new medications have coupons that you can use if you have a commercial insurance. If they don't have one, go to the manufacturer's website and print one off for yourself to take to your pharmacist. It can save you a lot of money. Well, that's all I have today. I hope this is helpful. Make sure you check out our other videos for information to help you make your medical decisions. So until next time, this is Family Med with Dr. Eric Richardson. Remember, please take care of your body because it's the only one you have.